Hello, and welcome to the Schoolhouse Test 5 video. For this video, I'm using the professional edition of the program. In this video, we will be looking at formatting the test and answer sheet documents with the title group. So you'll see I've already got a document up here, and I've got some data in design view. So what I'm going to do now is go into document view, and which is the test document, and answer sheet view, which is the answer sheet. And what I want to do is work on the title group, which is this first page area where you can put name and name of the test, a place for the student to put the name, that sort of thing. You can also format the header and the footer, and of course that's the top of the page and the bottom of the page. But the special thing about title group is it only shows up on the first page. It does share some of the same kinds of commands and look, but it only shows up on this first page if you want to use it. I'm going to look just at the test document title group, but the title group here in answer sheet view is essentially the same setup and same kinds of commands. And you may actually want to have both, if you're using the answer sheet, you may want to have this title group to look the same, or you may want something slightly different depending upon how you want to format your answer sheet. But in many cases, most of you will just be using the test document, so that's why we're going to look at just the title group for the test document, so this video isn't too long. So I'm going to click on title group, and the title group dialog opens. And some things that are common to the options pane over here, you'll see there's a bunch of options listed here. You can scroll down them all. But like these panes, you can either collapse them all or expand them all. And so I'm going to collapse them all just so it's a little easier to see what we have to work with. And the other thing that you'll find is when you click on an option, there's a little definitional area down here as well. And you can resize this to make it a little bigger, a little smaller. You can resize this whole window. So let's just collapse it all again. And the first thing we're going to look at is you, up here is a preview of everything that you're going to do. This isn't exact pixel for pixel as the page, but it's a really close representation of what you're going to see show up on the page. So every time you make a change here, so for example, if I go to lines and I hide them, you'll see it hides them there, and when I click OK, it applies that to the page. So that's it. So whenever you're working with these things, you'll see the effect of them right away, before you actually apply to the page. Then down here, of course, is the collapse all, expand all. This is save options. So what you can do is automatically save this if you've got something set up that you like to use all the time. And then those become the default when you build a brand new test. And if you like to make different changes for different options, but you don't always want to save that as your default, or if you've just set up a new default and you want to update a save test, then you can use this apply option. So this is to save what you've done, and this is to apply it to another save document. And then this is something that says save options on close. So unless you're going to be changing your test dialog for most tests that you work with, you may just want to have this save on close, and not, you don't need to actually do much with the save options or to the apply options. You just need to have it save on close. All right, general, the most important thing is if you don't want to use a title group, you don't want to use this thing at the very top, you want to do something else, or if you just want to use header and footer, if you uncheck visible here and then click OK, that hides the whole title group and it makes more room on the page. You may then just want to go ahead and use the header for that first page, but if you like to use a title group, we'll turn it back on. answer key indicator, this just puts a check mark on the page where if you have a picture where that would show up. Some of you might like to use that or not. And then this bottom padding is the between the title group and where your first question starts. So we have it defaulted to 5. Let's say if you change it to 30 and click apply, and you'll see it just creates a little bit more room in here. And what's the range for this? The range is 100, so if I put it up to 100 and I should just clicked into there, okay. And when you try these things out, you can see what difference it makes. So 100 is probably a little bit too big, though there may be a particular reason why you'd make it that big. So I think 20 is probably not a bad distance. All right, so that's if you want to hide the whole thing or if you want to make a little bit more room between your title group and your test area. You can add a picture to your document. This right now it's hidden, but you can add a picture. You can put it on the left or the right. And you know, for some of you, you may have a logo for your school or for your organization that you want to use. And of course, you can come in here. You can use something else. Oh, let's go with the butterfly here. And you can just leave, when you put your image in here, you can also paste an image in here or use another image from your computer. Leave this whatever size it is and click OK, and then this is where you control the size. So you can make it smaller or bigger, but let the program do the resizing, especially if you have any text on it or lots of lines if it's a company logo. You'll find you'll get a much better look if when you bring it in. Click here, come on. If you bring in your picture or logo at the biggest size that you work with normally, and then come in here and do your resizing here. So 110, let's go, and we'll just quickly see what this looks like, and that's what it looks like on our page. So you can add a picture to your group, to your title group here. I'm going to skip fields for right now. I'm just go to title. This is if you want to use a title on your page, and of course you can control the font. Type anything in you want. Instructions, you can put instructions in here, or you can hide them if you don't really think you need them. And again, you can control the font. And finally, there's the lines. We showed how to hide those or have them appear. And of course, you can change the color and the width. Fields are probably the thing that you work with the most, and all of these fields that have some text in them can be customized. So I can type in here, I'll just put some nonsense in. This one's got date. Maybe you don't want to actually have an automatic date in. Maybe you want them to fill in a date. And then you can use some of the tags that we've got here. So here we have total marks showing up in here. If you don't show marks on your test, you can remove that tag and maybe use something else. So let's just get this definition up here. There we go. And these are the tags that you can use in any of these fields. For marks, total possible marks, total page count, file name, version number, and that's when you're randomizing. There's two different formats for date, and you can mix those with text. So for example, let's say I wanted to show the total pages on here. So let's put it in the middle here. Total exam pages, and then I would put my tag in and press enter, and you'll see that that goes there. And you'll see in the title group, when you're using the title group, it just put one in, and that's because it doesn't know how, when it's in this little dialogue, it doesn't know how many pages you have. But once it gets added to the test document, that's when the program can count the number of pages. So I have 3 pages, and it says total exam pages 3. So you can customize any of these fields, and if you don't want to use some of them, you can just remove the text. And when you remove the text, it removes the field. And if you're trying to save a little bit of room on the page, if you want a smaller title page, you can do that by just removing the text from the fields. You'll also notice, you can also save some room here with instructions. So if you wanted to take the instructions out, for example, those would be removed as well. All right. So that is just a quick look at title group. I hope this Schoolhouse Test 5 video has been helpful. If you have additional questions, please contact us at support@schoolhousetech.com.